so far this morning. Time now for our company call segment. We are joined by the President of Oriental Peninsula Resources, Ms. Caroline Tanchay. And good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for joining us. Earlier, I reported about that BHP Billiton report warning of flattening demand for iron ore out of China. China, of course, is a big customer for Philippine miners. Can you please tell us, are you concerned at all about this warning that demand might be going down for metals in China?
Yes, we are concerned, but we are not concerned as far as our demand for our ore is concerned. Mm-hmm. We're okay. We feel that we are geographically located. We are the nearest to China. So if ever there is a slight or there's a 50% slump in demand for iron, Philippines will still be a major source of nickel pig iron for the Chinese market.
Right. It's also important to make the distinction that the BHP Billiton warning was for iron ore, and you, of course, are producing nickel pig iron, which is completely different. Is that correct?
Yeah, it has a slight. It's a slight difference. Yes.
Okay. Let's talk about your further business in China. You do have an agreement with Yunfeng. Can you tell us a little bit about that agreement? How you benefit from that partnership with Yunfeng? How far along is the agreement in terms of your production and your supplying to them?
We have a continuous relationship with them. Mm-hmm. We have a long-term contract with them. Mm-hmm. As far as supply of ore, we are also in the middle stage of doing the plans and detailed plan for our plant, mm-hmm. which is to dry the ore, which to beneficiate and to further process the ore to export a more finished product.
Mm-hmm. Well, I would imagine not too many people are familiar with Yunfeng. Can you explain what they do in China?
They produce nickel pig iron, mm-hmm. which is a raw material for stainless steel.
Right, right. And I understand that under the agreement, they will acquire 100% of your production from the new facility that you're putting up?
Yes,
that's correct. Okay, let's talk about your existing assets with City Nickel. How did it do last year, 2011?
We did very well. Mm-hmm. We were able to export about 1 million ton of ore. Mm-hmm. And we have declared net profit.
Okay, that's pretty good, huh? What are your projections then for 2012, given that performance?
Okay, we have opened a second mine this mm-hmm. year. We project to produce three times mm-hmm. of what we have produced in 2011.
Right. You have a new facility. Of course, the hot topic in mining right now is that executive order coming out of Malacañang. There are a lot of issues there. President Aquino mentioned that they might be banning mining in 78 ecotourism locations. They also mentioned that there might be these provisions that will allow government to get a 50% share out of mining revenues. How do you feel about that? Are you eager to see what the EO contains?
Of course. But as far as ecotourism area, mm-hmm. we are confident that we're not affected because our area is a mineral area.
Mm-hmm. Right. What about the sharing government? Are you concerned that the taxation might hurt your margins?
It may. Mm-hmm. So we're waiting for the EO.
What's your feel? Of course, you guys in the mining industry, you talk amongst yourselves. What's the general sentiment about the executive order? Is there a negative feeling about what's going to come out?
We are positive that our president is listening to all sectors right now. The president is not just deciding on what he feels like, but he is open to suggestions, and we're happy about that. We're still waiting, but everything is being discussed right now mm-hmm. from all stakeholders.
Well, how do you feel also about the anti-mining segment? They've been campaigning very loudly against mining. They say that government doesn't have the assets or the resources to effectively govern the mining sector to prevent any damage to the environment. How do you feel about that?
Okay, as far as we are concerned, which is Oriental Peninsula in Palawan, the Mines and Geosciences Bureau have closely monitored us and they have given us a thumb mark on how we protect the environment in our area. Mm-hmm. We don't do processing. We don't introduce any chemicals. Mm-hmm. We just export raw ore, which contains 50% iron, nickel, and moisture, mm-hmm. Which is, this ore is not also suitable for agriculture. Mm-hmm. We don't have environmental violation. We don't have processing right now.
Okay, moving on to another topic, your fellow nickel miner Nihao Mineral has been buying up some of your shares. Tell us a little bit about that. Is there going to be a possible joint venture with that company?
It may, but as of now, there's none.
Nothing yet. In the pipeline?
Not yet.
Okay, tell us a little bit about your plans for fundraising. You did mention that you are opening a new facility. How are you going to raise funds for that?
We raise funds internally, mm-hmm. From our profit.
Yep.
As of the moment, we don't have any plan of doing any fundraising.
None at the PSC?
None yet.
Are you sure your stock is actually trading at its highest level since your listing in 2007? It's 7.87 centavos a share. You have to be happy about that valuation. Yes. Don't you want to take advantage of that?
Not now.
Not right now.
We want to give value to our shareholders.
Okay, all right. With that, we'll have to end our interview this morning. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you, Mario.
That was Ms. Caroline Tanchay, President of Oriental Peninsula Resources Group. Moving back again to the PSEI, it's still in the red right now, down about 0.4% at 5,080.41, down 21 points from yesterday's close. Again, it's being dragged down by index heavyweight PLDT, which is down 1.3% right now, 2,630 pesos a share. Moving to the foreign exchange market, as of 9:50 this morning, the pesos at 43.036 against the US dollar. Volumes at $270 million so far. I'll now turn you over to Paolo for our health beat on air.